some interesting comments about why I would ever possibly consider running a weapon bar with teeth. I mean, the teeth just come off and you lose them, right? Well, it's really only happened a couple of times, but I'm going to go into some of the reasons why that would be an option. Okay. So here's some weapon bars on Tombstone right here. This one here is a solid steel weapon bar. You can see it's an inch thick. This one over here is an aluminum bar with steel teeth at the end, and it's 2 inches thick. So it's massively bigger than this one. The thing is, these two weapon bars, they weigh about the same, okay? So you only have so much weight to work with, so you have to maximize what you can do with the weight that you're given. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into some of the math of why this is a viable choice for a weapon for delivering big hits.
So a resource that I use frequently to figure out kinetic entry is the Team Cosmos website. Okay, if you go to the teamcosmos.com website, under resources, there's a kinetic energy calculator. And this is a way for you to figure out the kinetic energy of your robot without having to do the math yourself. So we'll click on that. Here you can see the different components that you can add. And what we're going to do is we're going to figure out the kinetic energy on Tombstone for the different weapon bars I just showed you. So first we're going to set it up for the steel weapon bar, which is 36 inches long, 7 inches wide. It is an inch thick. It is made out of steel. The weapon spins at 2500 RPM. So when it's all said and done, we have a 71.5 pound weapon. And spun at 2500 RPM, I've got just over 80 kilojoules of energy. Now this is a lot. This is substantial. This is certainly plenty to be effective. So this is what we get with the all steel weapon bar. 71.5 pounds, 80 kilojoules. Alright? So let's figure out what the numbers are for the aluminum bar with the steel teeth. It is also 36 inches long. It is also 7 inches wide, but it is 2 inches thick, and it is made out of aluminum. So that weapon bar without the teeth is just over 50 pounds. So let's add the teeth. The teeth are 6 inches long. They are 3 inches wide. They are 2 inches thick to match the thickness of the bar. For the distance, you've got to pick the center of the spin circle to the center of the tooth. So it's the center of that 3-inch arrangement there. So that is 15 inches. All right? And there are 2 of them. And they are made out of steel. So we've got just over a 50-pound weapon bar, just over 20 pounds for the teeth. The total weight is 70.85 pounds. It is less than the weight of the all-steel weapon bar. But look at the numbers here. So it is 103 kilojoules. It's over 20% more kinetic energy based not on the weight, but where the weight is, because the steel is all the way out at the end. So this weapon system holds significantly more kinetic energy.
So hopefully now you understand why this is a valid engineering choice for the robot and why it will continue to be an option for Tombstone going forward. If you like our videos, please like and subscribe. And if you have any comments, I'd love to hear them down below.